While watching this videotape, stop after each section is viewed. Complete that section and then proceed to the next step. 200 years ago, in a thunderstorm, Benjamin Franklin felt the awesome power of invention when he discovered the power of electricity. Many successful businesses were founded by inventors. Thomas Edison, Edison Electric Company. Alexander Graham Bell, Bell Telephone. Henry Ford, Ford Motor Company. And the list goes on and on. The power of invention. A simple step-by-step video guide to cash in on your creativity and successfully develop, protect, and market your ideas. This video contains the following sections. Where do you begin? How to protect your creativity? How to prepare your presentation package? And how to market your product? We have all been exposed to the growth and changes that evolve through necessity and time. Success requires certain tools. Given these tools, each one of us can achieve our own individual goals. Perhaps yours is financial, environmental, medical, or one within the arts. The direction you choose is yours, but the achievement of your specific goals may need guidance. Here is where you and Alan can work together. You may not know who Alan Amron is, but if you spend any time with children, the odds are you've come across one of his inventions. What was once known as a squirt gun is now a high-tech, super-powered, battery-operated, pumped, drenched, and soaked water gun industry. He's taken a simple squirt gun that sold $3 million per year and helped turn it into a new industry worth well over $200 million in annual sales, and all with a simple invention. And now the inventor of the battery-operated water gun, Alan Amron.
Hi, I'm Alan Amron. You're about to see my formula for successfully bringing your creativity to market and protecting it as well. You might be asking the question, how do I get into inventing? Well, in order to invent and get into inventing, you have to understand what inventing means. Inventing is fulfilling a need, solving a problem, or making something new, novel, and unique. Another question you might ask is, how do I know if my idea is good enough to pursue or take to market? Well, first you have to test it out on friends and family and get a gut reaction. See whether or not they like it or not. If they don't like it, you still have to go with your gut feeling and use their criticism creatively. Look at the following chart. These three questions will help you decide whether your idea is good enough to pursue or not.
Does your idea provide a solution to a problem? Does this solution already exist? Is your creation new, novel, or unique?
You just came up with this great idea. Now what? First thing you should do is you should write it down to explain it. Draw it to show it. Make it to demonstrate it. Protect it to keep it. Promote it to get exposure for you and your product, and license it to reap financial benefits. I'm making this videotape to help you. Please, help yourself. Follow the video step by step, and by the end of the video, you'll have your creativity ready to go to market.
Where do you begin?
Okay, now let's take all these points into more detail. First, you should write it so that you can get your point across to other people about exactly what it is that you just invented or you just created. By writing it, you're able to take it from your head and put it down on a piece of paper that somebody else could pick up and read and understand what you came up with. Then you should draw it. Draw it to show it to somebody, to actually be able to see what it is you have in your mind. Part of my success has been that I follow through on things right away. I suggest today you take your drawing and your written description and file for your document disclosure with the Patent Office in Washington. Now let's take a look at how you do that.
Your disclosure document should include the following. 1. Prepare a written letter to the attention of the Commissioner of Patents and Trademarks. 2. Include your written description. 3. Include your drawings, sketches, and/or photographs. 4. You must make 2 copies of the original paperwork and sign both copies. Keep the original letter and drawings to hold for your own records. 5. Insert these two copies into an envelope addressed to the Commissioner of Patents and Trademarks, Washington, D.C., 20231, and send it by certified return receipt requested. 6. Enclose a check or money order in the amount of $10, made payable to the Commissioner of Patents and Trademarks. 7. You must also enclose a self-addressed stamped envelope, which will eventually be sent back to you with one of your original letter submissions, stamped with a document disclosure number. The disclosure document is not an actual patent application, and the date of its receipt in the Patent and Trademark Office will not become the effective filing date of the actual patent application to be filed. This procedure begins the initial process of protection, which lasts for a 2-year period. Unless the invention is referred to in a follow-up letter or in a patent application, the original disclosure document will be destroyed at the end of this 2-year period. It's important to follow up this procedure within these 2 years with the actual registration of the patent in order to fully protect your invention.
If you do nothing else up to this point and you stop watching the tape, that's okay. But at least send in your document disclosure forms to Washington. Protect yourself. At the minimum, mail it out today. At this point, your conception date is now protected. You can go out and discuss this with other people in the rest of the world, but when you talk to people in the business world, you should definitely get a non-disclosure form signed first before you describe your idea. Now you should create a logbook to keep all of the information you gathered together on this particular project in one location. For example, you should put in the phone numbers, names, and addresses of all the people you contact, the letters, the correspondence. Anything that has to do with this project should be put in this folder, and then later on this would help prove, in court if ever needed, the conceptual date of the invention. Now I'd like you to take the drawing that you have for your document disclosure form, and I want you to make it into a more presentable drawing. Either you do it yourself if you can do it yourself, or send it out or bring it to a professional artist.
Cost of the artist should be anywhere from $50 to $550.
You can make a deal with the artist for 5% of the revenue you get in from this product. By making the product into a working model, you can actually demonstrate to somebody how it actually works or what it actually is. In the case of a song, you might want to make a demo tape. Go into the studio and record something that you could send out for someone to listen to. Or in the case of a book, you might want to finish the transcript into something presentable in a presentation.
How to protect your creativity.
The protection available to all of us by the United States government is patent protection, copyright protection, and trademark protection. Here's some examples of trademarks, patents, and copyrights so that you'll be able to select which one is in the category of your creativity.
1. Patents. Mechanical devices, chemical formulas, product designs, and biological formulas. 2. Trademarks, goods or services, logos, names, phrases, styles and looks of products or services. 3. Copyrights, forms of expression, works of art. Patent. If you'd like to do a patent search to see if your invention already exists, you can do it personally by contacting the Scientific Library of the Patent and Trademark Office at Crystal Plaza 3, 2021 Jefferson Davis Highway, Arlington, Virginia, or have an agent or attorney do it for you. It could cost anywhere from $200 to $1,500. To file for a patent, the cost is approximately $1,000 to $5,000. Patents last from 14 to 17 years, depending on the type filed. While searching and or filing for a patent, you must display a notice of patent pending on your product. And when your patent is issued, you must display the notice of patent number. And it's important to note that it's against the law to display the words patent pending on your product if you have not actually filed. Trademark. A trademark search will determine if there's any existing trademark that might prevent yours from being approved for issue. A trademark search can range anywhere from $85 to $200. The filing fee for a trademark. While filing and or searching for a trademark, you must display a TM at the end of your trademark. After the trademark is issued, you must display a small R in a circle to show registration. You can file yourself or with an attorney. located at the United States Department of Commerce, Washington, D.C., 20231. Copyright. If you want to personally do a copyright search to see if there's anything similar to your creation, contact the Copyright Office, Library of Congress, Washington, D.C., 20559. To speak to a copyright information specialist, the Copyright Office will conduct a search for you at the rate of $20 per hour. The filing fee for a copyright is $20. A copyright lasts for the author's lifetime, plus an additional 50 years. A copyright notice must be displayed upon creation of your work, and looks like this. It must contain the letter C in a circle with your name and year of creation.
If you can't afford to pay for a lawyer, you should contact one and see if he'll work on a contingency basis. Approximately 10% would be a nice fair royalty to give out of your royalties. You can find a qualified lawyer by contacting your local bar association or the superintendent of documents. At the U.S. Government Printing Office, Washington, D.C., a publication entitled Attorneys and Agents Registered to Practice before the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office. At this point, I'd just like to tell you a little bit about the people out there that are advertising for inventors to come in with their invention that we could protect it, license it, and make it for you. Be very cautious. If you want to work with these people, that's fine. But if it sounds too good to be true, it is too good to be true.
How to prepare your presentation package.
Okay, up to this point now, we have all our information together, and now we have to prepare ourselves a presentation package, something that's presentable enough for us to send out to the world to know what it is that you have, to see if they're interested in licensing it from you. First thing you would do is want to make a prototype, a looks-like, works-like prototype. Here's an example. The next thing I'd like you to do is make a four-color picture of your prototype. Then I would like you to take a 35-millimeter picture of your prototype that would be suitable to put in with your package. Try to keep this within the environment of what your invention was intended to be used for. For example, I invented a water gun. I took the water gun that I invented, the prototype looks like, I gave it to a couple of children to play with, and then I videotaped it, or I took a picture of it. These are great ways of communicating what it is that you've actually invented. When you do take the picture and when you do put the invention in its environment, try to take the hook of your idea. The hook of an idea is something that makes it magical, something that communicates it quickly to the rest of the world. Like with my water gun, it's the thrill of seeing water pumping out as soon as you pull the trigger. Take that hook in your creativity and put it into your video, into your pictures, and into your presentation. Okay, here's one way you can make a simple video. First, use a camcorder that you own or a friend of yours has that you can borrow. Don't shoot too close or too far away from the lens. When you're demonstrating, demonstrate with some background music that's played low. Also demonstrate what you're doing as you're doing it to describe what your product is doing.
The first ever 12-volt battery-operated air gun hockey game. The object of this game is to get the ball into the goal to score. It uses a lightweight ping pong ball.
Here is the first 6-volt battery-operated air power T-ball game. The air power suspends the lightweight ball above the tee for more natural bat and ball contact. It eliminates knocked over tees. Floating ball improves hand-eye coordination.
First thing you should do when you get your presentation completed is try it out on your family and friends. See their reaction. Don't get turned off by what they say, but use their criticism again for creativity.
How to market your product.
The next thing you have to do is market your product. I don't recommend that you do the product yourself. I recommend that you go out and license it. There's too much risk as far as liability and financial risk to take it on your own. To look for a potential licensee for your product, go to a local store that sells the product that's similar or in the same kind of a category as your invention or creativity. If it's a song, go to a music store. If it's a water gun or a toy, go into a toy store. If it's a clipboard, go into a stationery store. If it's food, go into a supermarket. When you go into these stores, look around for an item that's similar to what you've created. Look on the back of the product. Usually the name and address of the company is on the back. Keep a list of these names and addresses. When you get home, call information and find out the phone number. Then you can call up these manufacturers and find out who's in charge of research and development or new product submissions. Get their name and try to talk to them. Try to set up an appointment with them to show them your idea or your creativity. Or if you can't, try to get their name and address to send them a letter or a package with your presentation in it. After you speak to these secretaries or the people that you're talking about your idea to, if you can tell them about your idea on the phone, there's nothing wrong with it, as long as you document and put into your logbook who you spoke to and the date and what you said. If you'd like, you could follow it up with a letter. This letter would clarify who you spoke to, what you said, and all the details of the conversation. That way, you're basically protected, aside from the fact that you tell these people on the phone that you've already filed the necessary papers in Washington. Your presentation package should include the following. A cover letter explaining that you are a known inventor, a brief description of your product or design, a copy of the videotape or photographs, a demo tape and picture of the group if it's a song, a copy of the transcript if it is for a book, a four-color rendering, include a non-disclosure two copies signed by the originator of the idea, include document disclosure number if you've received it from Washington. If you did finally end up getting an appointment to see the person you have to see, set the appointment up. When you go to the appointment, be on time, wear the proper attire, and while they keep you waiting in the waiting room, don't think about your presentation. Think about what's around you. Read the walls, read the people, read what's going on. If you have time, speak with the secretary if she's friendly. In the meeting, you should never aim too high. If you go into the meeting with the attitude that you just want to communicate your idea to another human being and that the CEO of a company or a person in charge of research and development is not the title, it's a human being. Go in there and just communicate your idea. Don't think of going in there and that they're going to tell you, I want this, here's $1 million, and it's done. You go in there aiming low, you'll come out a winner. 70% of the people you see are going to tell you right in front of you that it's not for them, we're not interested, thanks anyway. The other 30% may get excited and say, you have to leave this with me, I have to show it to my boss, or we're having a committee meeting, I have to show it at the committee meeting. Every one of these guys usually have somebody they have to show it to. Even if they're the owner, they're going to have to show it to somebody. If they request that you leave your presentation, I suggest you do. Find out approximately when they're going to have this committee meeting so that you could follow it up with phone calls. You should also, when you leave there, write a letter confirming what the meeting was about and what you've discussed. If they're interested in your idea and they say they want to license it and they're ready to go, ask them for the phone number of their patent attorney or corporate attorney. You'll have your patent attorney or corporate attorney get in touch with them. This will speed the process up. In your agreement, you should either discuss or see a percentage for royalty of wholesale sales, an advance against future royalty, payback for your prototype costs, and you should be able to get a quarterly report as to wholesale sales. Also, once every year, you should be able to go in and check their books with an accountant. In order for you to collect international royalties on your product, what you have to do is 1 year after your product gets a patent in the United States, you have to file overseas. If you want to share this cost with your manufacturer because they believe they're going to do a lot of sales in those countries, it pays to do it. In some cases, it doesn't pay to do it. That's up to you and your patent attorney and your licensee. Don't ever get discouraged by turn down letters. Wait some time after that. Go into another invention. Work on another project. Subscribe to some of the industry trade papers to keep up on what's going in the industry. If a new company comes out, submit it to a new company. When your patent is finally issued or some time goes by, resubmit. If somebody should knock off your product and you have a patent on it, either have your patent attorney send a notice to that company or send a letter like our samples we have of notification of infringement. When you notify them of infringement, give them 10 days to answer. If they don't answer you in 10 days, file suit. You obviously can't file suit yourself, but get your patent attorney to be strong. Don't just listen to him saying, well, let's give him some more time. If in 10 days they don't answer, they're ignoring you. Sue them.
Here is Jerry Dunn, former patent examiner, and now New York patent, trademark, and copyright attorney.
Working with Alan Amron has proven to me that his methods are successful. We have successfully enforced patents and ideas that Alan has had against those who have knocked off his inventions. And the importance has been our persistence in not backing down. The importance has been our thoroughness in making sure that everyone that's infringing a patent is put under the pressure to honor the patent, to take a license, or to stop selling infringing goods. We have had good success because of our persistence. We have had good success because of our even-handedness, and we have had good success because no matter how large the company, no matter how powerful the law firm standing behind them, we will fight in court to enforce our patents and ensure that the rights that are granted by the patent office are enforced by the federal courts. And you too can do this if you have persistence and do not back down from those that are infringing your patents. Remember, the government has granted you a right, and the federal courts of the United States will enforce it.
7 years went by before anything happened with my water gun. And what happened was, one day I was walking through a toy store with my wife, and we noticed that there was a battery-operated water gun on the shelf. So I picked it up, and I was excited and sad at the same time. Excited that somebody was making it, and sad that I wasn't being paid for it. So I notified that company, and the next thing you know, I had that company under license. And within the next 4 months, the success of that product brought on more manufacturers to call me to want licenses.
The look, the feel, the sound, so real. Entertain.
The AK centerfire. The defender with pump action, up to 25 feet of firing power, and water clip for fast load.
The look, the feel, the sound, so real.
So that's how come today I have 25 different styled battery-operated water guns in stores across the country and around the world.
Hey, friend, the fun never ends.
Snap it, snap it.
Hey, chump, don't pump.
Snap it.
It's automatic. The color disappears, the fun never ends.
Pulsator and super saturated water guns come complete with red or blue concentrated disappearing liquid.
Snap it, snap it.
Shoots lots of feet, can't be beat.
Snap it, snap it.
DY, motorized.
Snap it, snap it.
The color disappears, yeah. The fun never ends.
Snap it.
Only for Benton.
Introducing Shock and Shoot, the powerful new voice-activated water weapon.
Don't shoot. Nothing in my hands.
Hey, man, we're not gonna shoot.
Get him.
It's hands-free, no pumping. Shock and Shoot. You shot, and it shoots.
I just love to shoot my mouth off.
New voice-activated Shock and Shoot from the water power arsenal of Cap Toys. Who else?
Freeze.
Yeah.
Let's soak him. Yeah, get him. You wouldn't shoot a guy in the back now, would ya?
So
good! Fire,
don't
fire,
mess
fire,
with
fire, fire,
Shout
fire,
and Shoot
fire,
2!
Fire! Gotcha!
You shout, and it shoots!
Take a bath!
In any direction!
Fire! Now this is what I call back talk. Fire!
Voice activated multi-directional Shout and Shoot 2! New from Cap Toys. Who else?
Where is he? Soak him!
Now comes the ultimate water weapon, Robo Blaster.
It's water time!
No pumping required. From its giant water pack, Robo Blaster shoots from your finger and soaks without mercy.
That was a blast.
Robo Blaster from Cap Toys. Who else?
To get the most out of this program, follow each section step by step. And use the checklist located on the video cassette label to guide you to your exciting goals. Now let's briefly review the steps necessary to bring your creative ideas to market. Step 1. Begin by following these 6 easy steps. Write it to explain it. Draw it to show it. Make it to demonstrate it. Protect it to keep it. Promote it to get exposure from it, and license it to reap financial rewards. Step 2. Protect your creativity by keeping a thorough logbook of all information and correspondence you have with your product. Include all drawings and written information, as well as names, dates, and conversations with others. File your document disclosure as soon as you have written your product description and drawing. Determine whether your product needs a patent, trademark, and/or copyright. And file, or have your lawyer or agent file the appropriate documents. Step 3. Prepare your presentation with a prototype, manuscript, picture, photograph, or video. Remember to use the hook in order to emphasize the excitement or uniqueness of your product. Step 4. Market your product by locating a potential licensee and contacting the person in charge of new product submissions. Try to set up a meeting. Remember to be yourself and to simply communicate your idea. If you cannot meet in person, send your presentation through some type of documented airmail carrier. Follow through with a phone call and a letter. Have a lawyer or agent make up or negotiate your contract. Keep abreast of trade publications and new products in your field. And if you see someone copying your product, go after what is rightfully yours.
Gus, you know, I think the scenario here is that you're asleep.
But I'm having a little fun here, Mary. Hey, Mary, look at me for a minute. Got me? Hey, Mary!